Dear colleagues, my name is Varvara Kitaeva. Together with Alexei Kotov, we would like to present you an abstract on epilepsy in patients with anti-MOG syndrome. The anti-MOG syndrome is a group of demyelinating diseases of the central nervous system in which antibodies attack glycoproteins on the outer membrane of oligodendrocytes, or MOG. The aim of the research was to study the course of the disease in patients with anti-MOG syndrome with epilepsy. We observed 11 patients, 5 men and 6 women, with anti-MOG syndrome, aged 2 months to 46 years. 3 female patients, among them, had epileptic seizures. Today we present 3 clinical cases in which patients with anti-MOG syndrome had epileptic seizures. Let us have a look at the first case. In the first patient's case, epileptic seizures preceded the diagnosis of anti-MOG syndrome. In figure 1, you can see the MRI of the brain of the first patient. She had focal sensory epileptic seizures with intact awareness. A year before this MRI, the girl's left leg and left arm had become sharply numb. This MRI was performed after new episode of weakness and numbness in the left leg. Now let us have a look at the second case. There, the disease debuted with right side optic neuritis. 7 years later, epileptic seizures developed after childbirth, during which the blood-brain barrier could become permeable to circulating antibodies to MOG. In figure 2, you can see the MRI of the brain of the second patient after 5 years from the onset of epilepsy. MRI was done when seizures appeared after 1.5 years of seizure absence. Let us have a look at the last case. There, the disease debuted with headaches. Optic neuritis and ataxia appeared after the acute respiratory viral infection. Then myelitis was diagnosed. 1 year later, an epileptic seizures occurred. This patient had a combination of CADASIL syndrome with anti-MOG syndrome. In figure 3, you can see the MRI of the brain of the third patient when myelitis was diagnosed. In conclusion, I would like to say that epileptic seizures in patients with anti-MOG syndrome are frequent. In addition to anti-seizure medicines, anti-MOG syndrome should be treated. Under this condition, seizures are well controlled and generally have a favorable prognosis.